if there is a true national monument which acts like a focal point in our nation today, that is the Vivekananda Rock Memorial at Kanyakumari. It was conceived and labored for by the RSS Swayamsevaks, was blessed by Ramakrishna Mission, was designed by the Paramacharya of Kanchikamakoti Peetham, and whose first donation was given by Sri Chinmayananda of Chinmaya Mission of Rs. 10,000. All spiritual, cultural and national organizations came together to support it. The state governments, the central government, the parliamentarians, the common man also donated towards making this a reality. This was inaugurated on September 2nd, 1970 by then President of India, Sri V.V. Giri. So in today's video, let's see the story behind Vivekananda Rock Memorial and one man who made this possible. Namaskaram everyone, welcome back to Zesty Nimbo, this is Shrirekha. It's been a long time since I've made a video. I'll tell you the reason for this delay in my subsequent videos. Today, let's concentrate on the story behind Vivekananda Rock Memorial. This memorial stands today as a memorial for Swami Vivekananda as well as to Sri Eknath Ranade, who made this memorial possible. Swami Vivekananda came to Kanyakumari drawn by the spiritual power of the feet of Bharat Mata, which is actually Kanyakumari. It is the tip of Indian Peninsula. He prayed at the temple of Kanyakumari and he was drawn to the last bit of Indian rock in the middle of the sea. That is the same rock on which Devi Kanyakumari performed tapasya for marrying Shiva. So he couldn't afford the boat charges to go to that island, to go to that rock, and hence he swam from the shore to that rock and meditated on that rock for 3 days and three nights from December 25th to 27th, 1892. On the rock, we can also see the footprint of Kanyakumari. At this place, he got the mission of his life. He was enlightened. And after that, he went to the Parliament of World Religions and spoke about Hindu Dharma. And then he started the Ramakrishna Mission. And he gave a clarion call to the nation and said, "Arise, awake, and stop not till your goal is reached." After seeing Swamiji's photographs at the World Parliament of Religions, the Kanyakumari people realized that this was the same person who had meditated on that rock. Later, in Swamiji's memory, Kanyakumari people established a library. But this was not enough. They wanted to do more. So Vivekananda Rock Memorial Committee was formed. For some time, everything was progressing properly. But then the Christian community claimed that that rock belonged to Saint Xavier and they put up a huge cross there. There was a communal flare-up, after which the state government of Tamil Nadu removed the cross and said that this rock was indeed Vivekananda's rock where he meditated upon, but no memorial was supposed to be built on it, and put up security there so that nobody can go there and do any mischievous stuff. But then this was not acceptable to the Hindu side. So they requested RSS to help them build this memorial. RSS deputed Sri Eknath Ranade. He was nominated as the organizing secretary of Vivekananda Rock Memorial Committee. First of all, he wanted to take the blessings of Ramakrishna Mission before he started out on this work. So he went to Kolkata and took the blessings of the 9th president of Ramakrishna Mata Mission, Swami Madhavananda Maharaj. So he got the blessings from Swamiji. He faced difficulties at three levels. First, a section of local Christians were not allowing the memorial to be built for Swamiji. Second, the chief minister of Tamil Nadu at that time, Sri Bhaktavatsalan, took a stand that he will not allow any memorial to be built. Third, the central minister of that time, Sri Humayun Kabir, who was from Bengal and who was the minister of education and scientific research at that time, said that any memorial, if built on that rock, would destroy the natural beauty of that place. So he started with Humayun Kabir. He went to Kolkata and requested a meeting with the minister. But Humayun Kabir was not giving him any time. So Sri Eknathji called a press conference along with some Swamijis of Ramakrishna Mission and said that Humayun Kabir was opposing a memorial for the revered son of Bengal, Swami Vivekananda. The next day when the press reported this, Humayun Kabir did a volte-face and agreed to take back his comments and pose no more opposition for the idea of rock memorial. Second, he wanted to meet with the chief minister of Tamil Nadu, Sri Bhaktavatsalan. The chief minister was not willing to meet him, but Sri Eknath Ranade wanted to keep the dialogue alive. And he tried at a different level. He knew that if the chief minister got the directive directly from the Prime Minister of India, Sri Jawaharlal Nehru, and also from Paramacharya of Kanchikama Koti Peetham, whom Bhakta Vatsalan revered a lot, then there wouldn't be any objection. So he went to Delhi and spoke with Lal Bahadur Shastriji, who was also in support of constructing the memorial. Shastriji asked Ranadeji to get the signatures of all the MPs, which will create pressure on the Prime Minister. In the next 3 days, Eknathji collected signatures from 323 MPs of the parliament, cutting across all party lines and religious affiliations, with just this statement, saying that in the interest of our nation, to pay respects to Swamiji, can we not rise above our political, regional and religious colours. With this statement, all the MPs agreed and signed, and 323 MPs' signature was sent to the Prime Minister of India. Nehruji had to accede to this request and told the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Bhakta Vatsalan, to agree to this memorial. Bhakta Vatsalan also agreed, but said that there has to be a limit of 15 by 15 feet for the shrine on the rock. But then Eknathji again went to Paramacharya of Kanchi, who took a lot of interest in this memorial, and he himself designed this memorial. You know what was the height and the length of that shrine? It was 130 feet by 56 feet. So this was also agreed to by Sri Bhakta Vatsalan. So all the three difficulty layers were removed. So the Christian community agreed, Bhakta Vatsalan agreed, and Humayun Kabir also agreed. The work for the construction of the memorial started in great gusto. But there was a problem of money. Eknathji printed out 1 rupee folders to be distributed to all the country's people, including the people from Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh and all these northeastern states, so that they can also have the feeling that they contributed towards the construction of this memorial. So 85 lakh rupees were collected from the common people. Almost each state government provided 1 lakh rupees, cutting across party affiliations again. And the central government provided 15 lakhs. In total, 1 crore 30 lakh rupees was collected and was used to construct the memorial within a short span of 6 years. And the first donation of rupees 10,000 was given by Swami Chinmayananda of Chinmaya Mission. So in this way, the memorial was built, and on September 2nd, 1970, it was inaugurated by the then President of India, Sri V.V. Giri. And during the inauguration of the memorial, the Prime Minister of the country, Srimati Indira Gandhi, the Vice President of the country, Sri G.S. Pathak, and the 10th President of Ramakrishna Math and Mission, Swami Vireshwaranandaji, were also present. So this is how the Vivekananda Rock Memorial was constructed with the efforts of one man, Sri Eknath Ranade. He was also the person behind the Vivekananda Kendra, which celebrated 50 years in 2012. It was inaugurated in 1962 at the Vivekananda Rock Memorial itself, and which still functions, providing karyakartas for the advancement of Hindu Dharma. So this is the story behind the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, at which our current Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi would be meditating from May 30th to June 1st. 2024. I hope you have liked this story and the greatness of this rock memorial. I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, Namaskaram.